This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to find the inverse of a 3x3 matrix. And I'm going to do this by using an augmented matrix. So here's the matrix we'll be working with. It's 3x3, and it's 1, 0, 2, 2, 1, 0, 0, 4, negative 14. We want to find the inverse of this matrix. So the first thing we're going to do is create an augmented matrix. We're going to do that by taking this original matrix and making it the left side of the augmented matrix. For the right side of the augmented matrix, we're going to have the identity matrix, a 3x3 identity matrix. 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. And then we're going to use the gauss-jordan elimination method to take the left side and turn that into an identity matrix. And the result will be that the right side is the inverse of our original matrix. Okay, so let's get started with that. When we do gauss-jordan, we start with the first column. We want the element in the first row, first column, to be a 1, which it is. And then we want everything else in that column to be a 0. In the third row, I've got a 0, but in the second row, I've got a 2 in that column. So what I'm going to do is take the first row and multiply it by negative 2. So I'll have negative 2 times row 1, and I'm going to add that to row 2, and that will become the new row 2. So I can copy that first row. That's not going to change. 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 0. Then we have to work on the second row. I want negative 2 times row 1 element, column 1. So that's negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. I add that to the 2 in the second row, and that becomes a 0. Then I want negative 2 times 0, that's 0. I add that to the 1 in the second row, that remains a 1. Negative 2 times 2 is negative 4. I add that to 0, I get a negative 4. Then I've got negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. Add that to 0, it's negative 2. Negative 2 times 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. Negative 2 times 0 is 0, plus 0 is 0. And the third row remains the same, so I'll just copy that. So that's 0, 4, negative 14, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so the first column is now taken care of. I want to go on to the second column. In the second column, I want a 1 in the second row, second column, and I want everything else in that column to be zeros. I've got a 0 above the row, above that 1, but I've got a 4 below it. So what I want to do is take the second row and multiply it by negative 4. So it's negative 4 times row 2, and I want to add that to row 3, and that's going to become the new row 3. So I can copy over the first two rows. That's 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 0. Second row is 0, 1, negative 4, and then negative 2, 1, 0. But I have to work on the third row. I want negative 4 times row 2. I'm going to add that to row 3, and that will give me the new row 3. So negative 4 times 0 is 0, plus 0 is 0. Negative 4 times 1 is negative 4, plus 4 is 0. And negative 4 times negative 4 is positive 16, plus negative 14 is positive 2. Then negative 4 times negative 2 is positive 8, plus 0 is 8. Negative 4 times 1 is negative 4, plus 0 is negative 4. and negative 4 times 0 is 0, plus 1 is 1. Okay, so now the second column is taken care of. We can go on to the third column. In the third column, I want a 1 in the third row, third column. I've got a 2 there now. So I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal of that 2, which is 1 half. So I want 1 half times row 3, and that's going to become the new row 3. So I can copy over rows 1 and 2. 1, 0, 2. 1, 0, 0. Then 0, 1, negative 4, negative 2, 1, and 0. And I want to multiply the third row by 1 half. So I'm going to have 0, 0, then 1 half of 2 is 1, 1 half of 8 is 4, 1 half of negative 4 is negative 2, and 1 half of 1 is 1 half. Okay. First column's taken care of, second column's taken care of. In the third column, I've got the 1 that I want in the third row, third column, but I have to turn everything else into zeros. I've got to turn this 2 in the first row into a 0, and the negative 4 in the second row into a 0. So to take care of the 2, what I'm going to do is multiply negative 2 times row 3, and I'm going to add that to row 1, and that will become the new row 1. To get rid of the negative 4, I'll multiply 4 times row 3. I'm going to add that to row 2 and make that the new row 2. Okay, so let's start on that first row. I want negative 2 times row 3, and I'm adding it to row 1. Well, I begin with negative 2 times 0, so that's not going to change row 1. Another negative 2 times 0 is not going to change row 1. But then I've got negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. I add that to the 2, and I get a 0. Going over to the augmented half, I want negative 2 times 4 is negative 8. Add that to the 1 and I get a negative 7. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. I add that to the 0 and get a 4. And negative 2 times 1 half is negative 1. I add that to the 0 and get a negative 1. Now let's work on the second row. To do that, I want to multiply 4 times row 3 and add it to row 2 for the new row 2. So when I multiply 4 times 0, I get a 0. I add that to a 0. I still have a 0. 4 times the next 0 is 0. Add that to 1 and get a 1. 4 times 1 is 4. I add that to the negative 4 and get a 0. 4 times 4 is 16. I add that to negative 2 and get a positive 14. 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. I'm going to add that to 1 and get a negative 7. And then 4 times 1 half is 2. And now I can just copy over my third row. So that's 0, 0, 1, 4, negative 2, and 1 half. So on the left side of my augmented matrix, I've now got the identity matrix, which means that the right side is the inverse of the original matrix. And that inverse is negative 7, 4, 1. I'm sorry, negative 7, 4, negative 1. 14, negative 7, 2. 4, negative 2, and 1 half. Okay, so this is just a bunch of little steps. Each individual step is fairly easy, but there are so many steps, there are a lot of places to make mistakes. So basically, just practice this until it becomes fairly comfortable for you. Check your work to make sure that you haven't made any mistakes, and you should be fine. Okay, I'll see you next time.